Alright, we got an edible napalm video. It's only an hour and 7 minutes long. Oh dear. So this ought to be fun. So yeah, let's start off, but yeah, I'll do it in pieces, 10 minutes at a time and paraphrase it, I guess. But yeah, even the title is kind of funny, just because somebody's already used this title before. If being wrong was taxable, Edmendum would be fucked. Yeah, right. Sorry, you're just become a crazy fat man. That's all you're nothing better than that dickhead. Dickhead. Let's see. Ought to be fun. It should be. Let's hear what the beginning is.
Hey everybody. So this is a fucking video that a lot of you have been waiting for. This is the fucking big one. And all fucking honestly, it's a video that's been long fucking overdue. Maybe not on this particular fucking subject, but to this fucking particular user, yes. So, I'm finally gonna do a full out all frontal fucking assault on fucking Gary.
Yeah, right. See, this is long overdue. You see, so all the assholes, all the jackasses who gave me bullshit because, oh, I was, you know, mistreating the poor edible napalm. They hit me true colors, okay? True colors. And so that's the good news. I was right. Yeah, he wasn't worth saving. Yeah, I'll just play it and then get back to you. It looks like he's just going to do a lot of talking. I mean, he's going to play my whole video, which is cool. But, you know, an hour and 7 minutes. Obviously, I can't play his whole video. But if there's something outstanding, then, you know, I'll play it. But basically, I'll just paraphrase. I'll take notes. Get a pen. I'll take some notes. So, see you in a bit. Okay, yeah, we're 6 minutes and 10 seconds into the video. He's going to apparently say something, so I wanted to stop here, because he's going to say something about he looked into something. So we'll see how factual that is. He says he was content to take the high road. Right. Then he did tell the story of the conflict between us, and you know he just leaves out the part where he pointed Rob at a video, and then about the cigarette taxation, let Rob make kind of outrageous claims when edible napalm knows about my lawsuit, knows about the whole bullshit with the judges and all that kind of crap, and he let this guy just basically do a hatchet job. I mean, it wasn't. You know, wasn't even close to dealing with the facts of the circumstance at all, and so edible napalm has just shown himself to be pretty disgusting as a human being. I mean, he's basically defending the crooked justice system. I never got a fair trial and a fair hearing for my argument, and he thinks that's okay. And now he's going to defend it again. So we'll see. But anyway, then he called me Brett Keene with less fat and worse hair. What the hell is that? So where have I demonstrated a propensity to lie, asshole? Come on, fuck you. That's just bullshit. Then the fat jokes. Yeah, I threw a couple of easy shots at you, and then you came back with the bad hair and wrinkles thing. Yeah, I'm old, so yeah, I have some wrinkles. But my hair kicks ass. yours, you'll see how long yours lasts. Okay, let's see what you look like when you're 50, fucker. You're not going to make it to 50, obviously. Who made the video about who? I made a video about the subject, asshole, okay? I didn't take any shots at you in that video. I even speculated on the video. I wonder if he's saying that he's, totally against any kind of, free speech rights on the internet. I mean, he doesn't get this whole idea that our free speech has migrated to the internet where we don't have any rights anywhere here. There's no sidewalks. There's no roads that are public. There's no place you can stand with your placard. And he doesn't get that. I mean, so I left the video quite open. So I'm just saying that your video was obviously a lot more obnoxious and it was not on the subject, and mine was. I brought up conference report and the whole subject of the amazing atheist. But anyway, who fucking cares? Fuck you, you're bullshit. Then, I'm using the 1000% tax now just because, yeah, it's 5 years later. And the truth is, it is a 1000% tax instead of an 800% tax. It's an outrageous tax. And it keeps going up. They keep trying to inch it up anyway. They keep voting on it, because now it's getting so high, they kind of know that, if we go too high, people are going to start mugging people on the street to smoke cigarettes.
I looked up statistics of tobacco users versus alcohol users. Funny enough, there are none, which is fucking hilarious because it's like, hey, where does Gary get these fucking statistics? It's almost like he's pulling this shit out of his fucking ass, is it?
Okay, so now he's going to try to make a rationalization that somehow alcohol is some way taxed at the same percentage rates, and it's not even close. It's not even close. And those are statistics you can find. You can find out what the federal tax on alcohol is, and you can find out what the state tax on alcohol is. And again, it's not just about these direct taxation. It's also about the tax that they did when they did the lawsuit deal. The federal government gave the tobacco companies a free ride on lawsuits so they can't be sued anymore in exchange for a huge pile of money that the tobacco company has to pay the government. So, you know, add all this crap up, shithead. I mean, if you can't figure out that you're getting ripped off, what you can do is just go look up the production cost of cigarettes, and you'll find out that you should be paying about $4 or $5 for a carton of cigarettes. And instead, you're paying 60. And the rest is taxes of some kind of levy. So quit being you're just being a fucking asshole to defend this behavior. This government behavior is outrageous. They're taxing a minority vice that's an addictive substance to boot. And they're doing it pretending they care about kids. When if they didn't want kids to smoke, they would just register cigarette smokers right now. You'd get a prescription to get your cigarettes, and then kids wouldn't have any access to cigarettes.
Interesting. One thing, though, I did find out, and this was fucking rather interesting, there is a huge correlation between fucking alcohol users and tobacco users, and vice versa. If you fucking smoke tobacco, you are...
Yeah, vices, that's right. People, yeah, they probably see more hookers, too. People who drink probably, on average, visit prostitutes more. They probably more, on average, have herpes. They probably more, on average, have pending lawsuits against them. Duh.
Are 3 times more likely to drink alcohol, and the same with fucking alcohol. So it's kind of funny that a lot of these fucking minority cigarette smokers are also part of the majority vice, alcohol.
Exactly my point, right? So now they don't tax the majority vice because the majority wants to keep their majority vice free. They didn't use taxation during Prohibition, did they, shithead? So why don't you look that one up? Why don't you look up the fact that when they wanted to prohibit alcohol, they could have done it with a tax by modern standards, right? They could have just made the tax impossible for people to drink anymore. And instead, they had to go to the states and do the whole constitutional amendment shit. Because they couldn't have gotten away with it back then, because the justice system had more integrity back then, and you obviously couldn't tax a fucking vice. Unless you had a damn good reason. Discriminatorily. Outrageously. It's called, you know, the idea is the same idea behind cruel and unusual punishment. Okay, taxes are in effect. It's even been said so in Supreme Court decisions where they've actually written words like that. The power to tax is the power to destroy, to harm, to crush. And so it has to be applied with standards. You can't just sit there and say, nail them for as much as we can get because they're a minority.
That you would think these people, if they fucking felt like such a fucking discriminated minority, they'd use that fucking alcohol clout they fucking have. But oh wait, that doesn't fucking happen.
How does the alcohol clout have anything? They're not a majority, okay? They're still a minority that drink and smoke, shithead. You can't even do that logical cognition and figure out that. Oh, yeah, well, if most cigarette smokers drink, that means they have a majority somewhere. No, jackass, there are still a minority of people who drink. It's still only a 10% of people who drink are cigarette smokers, dopey. Oh, God. Fatty, dopey, sleepy, drunky, stony. All right, well, I'm not going to bother you. I thought he had some point to make. No point. No relevant data whatsoever. I did some research and came up with nothing. Thank you. Wonderful. Fantastic argument. I'm totally destroyed. Okay, I'll be back. Ah, this is just pathetic. Okay, so I only got to 8:13 now. So he's completely done the same thing Rob did. This just keeps happening. The judge did this very same thing. So this is something I wrote a whole bunch of in my appeal papers. Because I only used the word excessive, like, you know, when you count it up like 8 times in my complaint, okay? Excessive taxation. I never claimed you couldn't tax a vice. I never claimed you couldn't tax anything. Yes, of course you can tax things, but the law says, the Constitution said, not the Constitution, the Supreme Court decisions have said, you can't tax with deliberate inequity, okay? The tax scheme has to be, the intention has to be equitable distribution of the tax burden, okay? That's the law. All right, and what I'm saying is that 800% tax on a minority vice can't possibly be contrived into something called equitable when there are vices so much more destructive to the health and welfare of human beings. So this is preposterous. The only reason why cigarette taxes are so high is because it's a minority vice. They're clearly being exploited, it's clear discrimination, and it's clearly inequitable taxation. It's clearly excessive taxation. And this fucking cunt brings it up again after he's had this run through his face so many times. There's no possible way he could make this mistake. All right? It's just a deliberate lie. Fuck. And so he ends, he talks about the whiskey rebellion, explaining to me how, you know, the government went in and said, no, we can tax alcohol. Duh. I mean, the judge wrote it in his papers. The government can tax cigarettes. That was his response to me saying cruel and unusual taxation. That was my description. That was in my complaint. Those exact words. Cruel and unusual taxation. My complaint. So you're just such a lying scum.
Like the tax on the whiskey farmers. Gary. So, yeah, the fucking founders totally didn't want vices to be fucking taxed, did they? And also, Gary, you're going to...
Yeah, also, right. Straw man, liar, fuck you. All right, you just plain suck for pulling that kind of bullshit.
Get into this shit. It's like, oh, it's about health. Fuck it, no, it's not, Gary. That's, like, right there. That's why I say you don't...
Oh, man, you're too stupid. You're just too stupid for this conversation. Go read the record of every legislative body that has debated increasing the cigarette tax, and it's all about health. God, you're such a scumbag. You know, it's about kids especially. They're using kids as an excuse to exploit, and that's all it is. And if you can't see that... You're just too fucking stupid for these words. Anyway, I'll get back to it. I really don't want to play 1 hour and 7 minutes worth of video. So I'm going to have to try not to react. But he's just, obviously, he's just going to lie for 1 hour and 7 fucking minutes. Wow, this guy is just too stupid. And what he's defending here is so offensive. I mean, he's basically saying, yeah, okay, it's just about the money. The government is doing it just for the money. He's almost conceding the fact that it is discriminatory, you know, and it's on top of, like I said, it's an addictive substance. And now he's claiming that somehow the government's going to benefit if they tax cigarette smokers and a large percentage of them eventually will have to quit. They'll literally have no choice, right? I had to quit because I couldn't afford to smoke. I mean, it's just a fact. It's unaffordable. And if you save their lives, they're going to cost more money. They're going to live longer and cost more money. You get more expensive exponentially as you get older. The longer you live, the more expensive your death will be. That's a statistical fact. And so he's saying that somehow they're doing this in some sort of rational monetary interest. Well, there is no rational monetary interest because in the end, it won't be about the money. Okay, they'll save some money now, they steal the money now in taxes, but they're going to pay more in welfare and Social Security and hospital care in the future. So they're not going to win monetarily. So that's a bogus argument to make. And again, my point about the kids was the fact that's how they've sold this as a fucking viable extortion and exploitation. The way they've made these laws passable is the fact that they keep whining about kids.
Especially with fucking people who smoke, they're gonna fucking drop dead. Like, you've said it your fucking self, Gary. Tobacco users are a net fucking gain for the system. They get fucking soaked for taxes, and then they die before they can collect any of the fucking money when it comes to fucking healthcare. You yourself have stated numerous fucking times the reason that there's fucking such a high tobacco tax, but you don't fucking see it.
I see it, and I'm saying that's unconstitutional. It's fundamentally unconstitutional, you retard. The government can't do that. That's what those fucking Bill of Rights is for, you fucking dumb cunt. Jesus Christ, you're stupid. All right. I really can't do this. All right, we're only 9 minutes into this fucking piece of shit. Ugh, okay. So just to catch up, so he did some crap about public intoxication is a crime. That's not the point, okay? You have to be too drunk for it to be a crime. Not just drunk. You can be drunk publicly. You just can't be too drunk. So that's bullshit right there. Then he says, you know, this is somehow about my vices versus your vices versus somebody else's vices. Again, it's not the subject, okay? The subject is this is an addictive substance, and it's a minority vice, and it's taxed preposterously excessive compared to all other vice substances. That's the subject, shithead. Pot isn't the subject. Other shit isn't the subject. The subject is should the government be allowed to tax minority vices excessively? I don't think Thomas Jefferson would say this is okay. If you think he would say it's okay to disproportionately tax minority vices, I think you're just too stupid. Because I think he knows that's exactly the danger. That's why they wrote a Bill of Rights, was to keep the majority from doing exactly this thing. Exactly this thing is what they wrote the Bill of Rights to stop. You stupid fuck. Okay, now listen to this shit. This is really... I don't know what to say here, but anybody defend me? Okay, so all the jackasses, you ragged on me about, disengaging from poor edible, the wonderful edible napalm. Now listen to this shit.
Yeah, and if we were worried about people's health, we wouldn't let people get as bitter and fucking depressive as you. We'd fucking drag you out into fucking streets and shoot your fucking ass like a fucking dog. We would do the humane thing and put people like you out of your own goddamn fucking misery because you're too fucking cowardly to do it your fucking self. And also, Gary, about fucking cigarette tax, I don't give a shit.
Right, because you're not living on your money, apparently, right? You don't have to go out and work for the money to buy the cigarettes, right? What the fuck? So this is like burning money. So he's breaking cigarettes to make some sort of point. Okay, he doesn't care that he's getting taxed to smoke cigarettes, a fundamental right, a liberty that's been around for hundreds of years that human beings have done, okay? Now they decide, and all of a sudden they're going to tax the fuck out of it. It's not accessible to poor people, so here you have a liberty that poor people can't afford to do anymore. The tax comes down to $200 or more dollars a month, okay? That is a quarter or a third of people's rent. That's what they pay for rent, just to smoke cigarettes. And you're going to play this kind of game and say, I don't give a fuck. And somebody's supposed to say that's a rational thing to say. I mean, I'm sorry. It's not rational. It's not reasonable. It's fucking insane. You're just a silly idiot. No. Okay, that's it. I don't care. So he just broke cigarettes to say, I don't care. I mean, damn. I don't know what to say to that. I just don't know. I don't know what to say to it. I have no words to describe what I have to say to that. I do care. Okay. I'd like to be able to smoke. I'd like to live in a free country where I can decide to smoke cigarettes if I choose to in my own fucking house. Yeah, that's what I would call a civilization. Is a place where I would have the liberty to do that, and I wouldn't be taxed out of that right. I mean, you just suck. Fuck you. Yeah, back again already. I mean, I just can't, maybe I'll just have to play the whole thing. So anyway, this is just so stupid.
Technically, right? So what? Right fucking there. Gary admits, I'm fucking right. I could stop this fucking shit right now because even Gary fucking admits I'm right.
Yeah, the point was is that whether YouTube is obeying the law, right? And Fred said, you know, basically not that, but I don't know why Fred came up in that section. But anyway, I'm just saying that, yeah, technically they've gotten away with it. Okay, but I don't think they can constitutionally get away with it. I think I could sue YouTube for discrimination. I think their terms of service are a lie. Okay, they violate their contract every single day because they don't equitably distribute any kind of this judgment. They delete channels and videos and accounts, okay, based on arbitrary standards that aren't consistent with any kind of rational standard. So it's not reasonable expectations aren't being met, and they have violated their own terms of service by having no definition to their terms of service. So I think a lawsuit could actually win. The point is, you can't file a lawsuit. You can't get anywhere in the American injustice system. But I don't think the company is operating consistent with its obligations. I think, like any other public accommodation, okay, they can't be guilty of discrimination. I think I can prove discrimination based on religion.
Why the fuck is this, why is there 14 fucking more minutes of this?
Oh, no point in playing all this. So he thinks, just because I said that word technically, and he didn't finish the explanation yet, so we'll see what he says to that. But anyway, I just really don't want to do this word for word. I'm really going to try to resist. I wrote down the word technically. I was just not going to ignore it, but I said, no, can't ignore it. But I'll try to do better. I'm sorry, but this is too stupid. I got to play it. It's too stupid.
I would argue that to be incorporated in America, you ought to have some respect for constitutional principles. And it's quite obvious that the public square has migrated to the internet.
Again, if you watch fucking Fred's video, he would fucking completely explain why that's bullshit, because the fucking public square isn't a website, it's the fucking people. We're the fucking public square, Gary.
Alright, isn't that the most idiotic notion ever? He's basically saying if you're a religion, you don't have to send missionaries out anymore. No, all you have to do is have your own little church congregation and talk to each other and missionary to each other. You don't have to missionary to the world. That doesn't have anything to do with anything. No, you don't pay attention. You don't do that. You just talk to each other. And there, you've had your free speech. You have the right to talk to the people in your house. And there, you have free speech. I mean, it's an idiotic notion of free speech. The whole point of free speech rights is the fact that you can get in the public's face, that you can get on a public street, that you can get somewhere where people who don't know you, who haven't heard what you have to say, will hear what you have to say, you retard. I mean, this idea that we are the public square is just idiotic. I don't even know what to say to that. It's so fucking stupid. It's just so fucking stupid. I mean, let's see what else he says.
And I know you have fucking trouble wrapping your fucking head around this, but YouTube is one of many fucking alternatives.
Oh, again. So then now just, all right. So you're offended because people call you a Republican or a fucking libertarian. And look at what you're saying here. You don't believe in monopolies anymore? You don't understand the concept of monopoly? You don't understand how that happens and how everybody migrates to it and it ends up getting all kinds of advantages because it's the biggest guy on the block? And that there has to be some kind of protections against that? Because you just end up with a single player eventually? Wow. Incredible. Fucking incredible. You're this stupid.
There's a video fucking sites out there, Gary. It doesn't fucking matter if they're...
Okay, so tell that to everybody, all right? So, yeah, so if the government says you can't protest within 10 miles of the White House, there, that's okay. If they say you can't protest on any street, you can only protest on back alleys, that's okay. If they say you can't even protest Wall Street from inside New York City, you have to be, like, in New Jersey or something to protest Wall Street. If they would have said that 20 years ago or 30 years ago, people would have said, this is outrageous. I mean, maybe they'll accept it today because, yeah, that's the world we live in. Everybody has turned into a fascist motherfucker, including you. And so you think that this is, you think that's free speech. Free speech is go out in the back alley, go out in the middle of, go next to the homeless guy in his cardboard box and have your free speech rights there. It'll be just so fucking effective. Man, amazing. Fucking amazing. Buy your own cable TV network. Yeah, that's a solution. Yeah, that was a smart judge said that. Buy my own cable TV network. Yeah, you think just like she does. Einstein, man, you're so smart. You think just like a superior court judge. Wow.
Fuck.
Oh, you do suck.
More fucking eyeballs on fucking YouTube than on Vimeo. Because here's the fucking thing, Gary. Like, you're gonna bring up fucking, like, cable companies and telephone companies and shit. Telephone companies. There was a fucking time, I can remember this shit, when if you were part of, like, Bell, and, like, what was another fucking telephone company from those kind of days?
Yeah, why don't you go back to before that? AT&T. Yeah. A little bit of a problem.
Bell. I can't, like, let's make up a...
Whatever. Let's just wait till later. I'd be back, no doubt. All right, it's next day. So, Edible Napalm's done his second video. So we have even more crap. But I mean, he's done a second video to my stick cam video. You know, the traditional, like, I might as well be drunk. You know, I'm heading into, it's 12 o'clock at night, and I'm heading into maybe 7 or 8 hours of shit. And this is my video going into, it's like going to prison video. And so he's going to do a response video to that. I don't think anybody's gone that low to do a response video to my announcement video, a video that's only up for whatever, 10 hours. But anyway, here's, he makes some sort of, he makes this stupid comment first about my appearance again. So I guess we're just going to do the appearance insults, which is fine. I mean, you know, it's okay with me. But, I mean, get real. I mean, this guy does an analogy, like if we were in a lineup, you know, with three people, you know, one third other person, and we were to pick the healthiest person out of the lineup, he thinks, I mean, he's so delusional. I mean, I'm 53 years old. You want to make a fair comparison somewhere, shithead? You know, fuck you. Even on my bad days, I'm doing better than most 53-year-olds.
It's so often. I mean, look, that's pretty much it. That's like everything you fucking do. Like, look at how many fucking projects you fucking have started and then just been like, feh.
Okay, whatever. He's just gonna make stupid noises. Okay, so I thought there would be something more there. Yeah, compared to who, compared to what, and why do things fail is because you assholes can't accomplish anything. You can't do anything. You're just so fucking useless and incapable. So, yeah, fuck you. Anyway, I'll get back to you. This kind of stuff does bug me, I have to concede. So, I mean, these people, okay, they're just a bunch of assholes. So you expect, you know, bullshit. But, you know, indifferent sky. This will be interesting. I have a feeling I'm going to agree with both of you. What do you want to agree with? Exactly. 1,000% tax on cigarettes. He's defending that now. U.S. constitutional, like Thomas Jefferson would say, yes, go ahead, you can tax vices as high as you want, especially addictive substances. Yes, that's totally consistent with American values. And then this whole idea of not recognizing that monopolies still exist on the internet. It's not a magic place where all of the capitalists don't still do exploitation. It's even easier for them to exploit on the internet. And that there's basic infrastructure that we've basically handed over to all these capitalist companies, that there is no public space, there is no public library, there is no public anything. And that if we're going to let the corporations run things that would traditionally be public, that we should at least regulate them into doing it somewhere close to in the American way. So what, do you agree with him that corporations should be running the internet, that they should own it, like they own cable TV now? I mean, fuck you people. Fuck you. I mean, fuck you. I mean, if you can't figure out who's being an asshole in this fucking debate, you're a fucking asshole. Yeah, sorry. That's how you could define asshole that way. If you can't figure out who's an asshole, you're probably an asshole. Fuck. So anyway. I'm going to try to just stop responding. I just let him say his shit, pick the two or three best shitty things he says and respond to that and just be done with it. But he's really terribly, incredibly irritating and uninteresting. Yeah. This new style of his is just useless. He's just a useless bag of whatever troll shit. He's just a troll now, officially. A big, giant, fat, ugly troll. He's read too many Lord of the Ring books and such. He's become a gork, or an orc, or a bork, or a flork. Shit. Alright, have made it to the 33-minute mark, which is some progress anyway. But man, the stuff he's defending is just so outrageous. So anyway, get to it. So first he griped on my projects not being completed, all this other stuff. I mean, obviously, the fact that I've tried to do stuff, I'm not going to be ashamed of any of that. And the real bottom line is any of the failures are not necessarily just my failures. Like I said, this stuff didn't get any support, okay? I mean, I make tools, I do different things, and it's just no support. And so, yeah, okay, I failed to do it good enough to seduce people to play along. Okay, I'll concede that point, but whatever. I just don't see how you can turn that into some kind of character flaw, asshole, because they were all stuff that I wasn't going to benefit from. So fuck you. Sandy shit. I don't know where that came from. Sandy shit. Shady shit. Oh, okay, so then he talked about shady shit. About Brett Keane or something. And it's just so funny because, I mean, he's admitted to playing these backdoor bullshit games all over the place anyway. So, I mean, and what shady shit have I been involved in? Oh, that's right. Absolutely none. Can't win against Napalm, the fat Batman. The Batman. Apparently he's just going to keep making videos or something, and if this is going to be the character of them, the quality of them, then yeah, they're just going to be a waste of time. So yeah, I will stop watching their videos, especially if they're this content poor. I mean, you're not making a rational argument on any of these subjects, and you're just making yourself out to be, like, worse than a Republican. I mean, really. You'll next be talking about the invisible hand. I mean, yeah, fuck you. You've left the building. The rational building, you've left it. YouTube isn't a public utility. It isn't a utility. And so he goes on this whole, intense tirade about somehow we're only supposed to be regulating things where lives are at stake. So if lives aren't at stake, the liberty interest doesn't exist, there's nothing to worry about here, nothing to see here. So if the library censored all kinds of books and did all kinds of stuff, the government shouldn't say don't do that. If the schools don't let people read evolution, yeah, that's okay, let them break that law. No lives will be, whose life is ruined by having to say the Pledge of Allegiance or to pray to Jesus or to have long sermons at the commencement ceremony. Nobody's life is going to be at risk, so we don't need any laws saying they can't do this shit. I mean, just outrageous rhetoric. I mean, outrageous. I'm not arguing that lives are being destroyed because YouTube doesn't allow free speech, but I'm saying free speech is incredibly important, especially on the internet where you're talking to the world and you're talking to people who don't even get access to anything called the truth ever. If it's going to get censored off of that, those public airwaves, it's important. And so he's still going to make arguments that, you can go to a back alley and put up your posters and your signs, but yeah, you just can't put any banners on the main street because the main street's owned by the corporations and the people that have the money, and anybody who doesn't have the money doesn't get to have a voice. And I just think that's outrageous. I mean, that's what he's advocating. That's what he's arguing for. Where's the fucking harm? Is his statement. And I could just add, from censorship. And that's what we're talking about, is YouTube is applying censorship. They're applying their standards in a double standard manner, and it's clear what they're censoring. My Do Not God account was censored There wasn't anything else that happened there. It's quite obvious they didn't like the content, they didn't like the name of the channel, and they used any excuse they could find, and they gave me 3 strikes for 2 images. You explain it. No, I can't. Skeptical heretic. Okay, so then he explains a story about the skeptical heretic, that somehow he had to go talk to the skeptical heretic and tell him to lay off and be easy and all this kind of crap. Like I needed protection from him. I know I kicked his ass, and I'd love to have the opportunity again. If he wants to talk about a real subject sometime, I'd love to kick his ass again. All right, because yeah, he's got nothing. And he's the one that gave up. Okay, I mean he's the one that disengaged the conversation by basically admitting, yeah, I'm a nihilist, selfish cunt, and so I don't even know what you're talking about when you're talking about ethics, philosophy. All right, and somehow there was some argument that somehow Rob has already explained something about public access TV, which is just bullshit. But the point is that it was regulation imposed. It was perfectly rational. It was perfectly rational in the court decisions written. I think by one of the best ones was the original black guy on the Supreme Court, Marshall. Really eloquent stuff about, you know, the fact that this is where the world is changing and that the changes have to be adapted to, and just this idea that we have principles in the fucking goddamn Constitution, the Bill of Rights, and as just a rational civilization migrates those principles into the new reality. And, that's the way it should be. You shouldn't have to pass civil rights acts. You should be able to find the truth in the basic ideals that Jefferson wrote about. Anyway, I'm not going to sit there and recontextualize great Supreme Court decisions, but the point is that, yeah, our rights are fundamental, and wherever society goes, those rights need to be protected from these new the changes that take place in new environments. And so, yeah, the Constitution should be a living document. You shouldn't have to rewrite it to make it work. But anyway, the point is that public access was a good idea. It worked when you could scare people with a lawsuit. It doesn't work anymore because you can't file a lawsuit in America anymore. Okay, the last public access lawsuit is probably 20 years old. It's just now given to the communities. They can do whatever the fuck they want. And as I demonstrate by going to New Jersey Superior Court, and the judge said, buy your own cable network. That was her response to my claim of being denied access to public access. She didn't even know what public access television was. And so, yeah, that game is over. And it wasn't because the law sucked. It's because the judges now suck. Okay, he thinks YouTube, so Edible Napalm thinks YouTube will somehow self-destruct, that these free speech violations will somehow mean something to somebody in the future, and that somehow YouTube will pay a price for its censorship. I think it's quite obvious that Google has gotten away with it all over the world. Their little catchphrase, don't be evil, has worked. They played the game, and they suckered everybody in. And it's not going to happen, all right? They're too big to fail now. It doesn't matter what they do now. They can do anything they want to do, and they'll get away with it. The fact that they got away with putting advertisements on every web page on the internet, something Bill Gates wanted to do, and everybody screamed and yelled, you can't do that, you motherfucker. And then 2 fucking years later, Google got away with it. Just because they had a little silly name. And they weren't Bill Gates. And that's the only reason why. And that's how fickle and stupid our society has become. And you're defending that idiocracy. I mean, you're just a defender of idiocracy. I think it's fat chance that anybody's going to be able to compete with YouTube. Just isn't going to happen. Because you have to have too much money and be too big a player. And there's no money in protecting free speech. You have to make it something required, not something somebody's going to... The fucking capitalists aren't going to give us free speech, jackass. The invisible hand isn't going to create that one, stupid fuck. Ugh, man. So yeah, he just talks a lot about how, you know, he thinks the Constitution is just about protecting us from the government, you know, and that's all it is, and that we don't have any real rights. We just have the right for the governments to somehow not to the government's the evil thing. So he's just become one of these anti-government motherfuckers who, of course, wants public health care and wants the government to give him all this other shit, but he just doesn't want the government to be involved in anything else, which is just so stupid. All right, changed public access. Let's see, create as the, I don't know. So anyway, he brought up UHF channels. They weren't public access channels. It's just that they were low budget channels, so they could afford to put on crappy content because they had very small broadcast ranges, and you know, they could finance the broadcast, so they were like public radio, you know, that kind of thing. So they survived on some of them on donations, and some of them they could make enough, just enough money to get by. So they could have really crappy programming and get by. But it wasn't public access. It was just, hey, I have a TV show. You want to be on it? That's what it was. All right. No compares. Let's see. No corporation did anything wrong. Okay, so he put those words in my mouth. So he was saying that when I was talking about the 70s and the fight and the fact that the government was involved and regulated, he said that means that I said that no corporations did anything wrong. No, my point was exactly the opposite. Corporations were just as evil as they are now then, but the difference is the government stopped them. Okay, it said no, you can't do that to Hearst, and it said no, you can't do that to the monopolies, to AT&T, to a lot of corporations, and it broke them up, or it did something else to say, no, you can't do that. And what it did when with television is it said, look, we'll see, you've turned television into shit, and so now we're going to oblige you to do certain things in the public interest. And those were good things. And then Reagan deregulated, and that's when all of a sudden you watched 3 hours of commercials to watch a two-hour movie. I mean, that's an exaggeration, but it's almost that bad on Turner, right? I mean, the last time I had cable, if you watched a movie on Turner, yeah, the first hour, yeah, maybe it was 15 minutes of commercials, but the second half of the movie was impossible to watch because it took 3 hours. The commercials were so obnoxious. A ruined life. So again, he went on about, so censorship doesn't ruin anybody's life, it doesn't kill anybody, therefore we shouldn't worry about it. It's no problem. Discrimination doesn't necessarily kill you, so yeah, we shouldn't have laws against it. We shouldn't protect people from, you know, this. I mean, we might as well go back to saying that, you know, companies don't have an obligation to serve blacks, right? If these kind of corporations don't have an obligation to serve people with philosophies they don't like, if corporations can decide, I mean, they're not going to let the sign, I've used this example, but the sign in Times Square, they wouldn't allow to be overtly discriminatory because they're basically a monopoly, okay? They have the monopoly signpost, and they're just not going to be allowed to discriminate in how they allow people to have access to that. And so, you know, that's all you were saying about the internet. The internet should be the same way. If you have a monopoly position on the internet, you're going to have more responsibilities than if you don't have a monopoly position. Is that logic just escape you altogether? Fuck. Okay, then it really gets outrageous. Let's see. My liberty interests don't have to be yours. Oh, yeah, well, so, yeah, I don't know if I want to really get into that, but, you know, I mean, clearly the fact that he doesn't give a shit about censorship and the right to free speech, well, frankly, I care more about that than the government telling me how long I should live or how much or whether I should die or not or all this other shit the government's getting into. So my liberty interests aren't your liberty interests, asshole, and I'm going to fight for the ones I think are important. So fuck you. All right, so then he comes up with this crazy line, something better to tax. So that's what he actually said about cigarettes. Is there something better to tax? Yeah, there is a lot of things better to tax, okay? Guns. You want to talk about damage to society? Well, then certainly alcohol would be on that list. So yeah, tax it at the same kind of percentage rate, make it unaccessible to the poor, and you're certainly going to do society an awful lot of good, right? You stop poor people from drinking, it's gonna help society, no doubt about it. Get you off the pot, maybe. Let's continuing. Yeah, I wanted to finish the point about the something better to tax. All right. Well, Edible Napalm already knows I've never suggested that taxes should be placed on liberties. Okay, yeah, the fact is liberty shouldn't be taxed, you know, beyond the burdens the liberty creates. So if you're a boater, you should pay a tax to pay for the Coast Guard to go rescue you now and then. If you're a mountain climber, you should pay a tax to pay for dragging your body off the mountain. Whatever your liberty costs society is what you should be taxed. That's the way it should work. And if you have kids, you should pay the freight. Yeah, they should be educated properly, and their health care and all that stuff should be the responsibility of people who have kids, not people who don't have kids. Liberty shouldn't be taxed beyond the social cost of the liberty. And the fact is, there is no social cost to cigarette smoking. Cigarette smokers do not die more often. They don't do anything. If there is a difference, it's a small difference. And so the tax should be 1/10 of what it is, 1/100 of what it is in practical fact. And that's the way it should be. We should be taxing, we should be equitably distributing the tax burden. We should be taxing inheritance. And we already know my philosophy on this stuff. So to say shut the fuck up, I think cigarettes are the worst thing to tax socially. It's an addictive substance. Even if you thought it is appropriate that nobody should ever start smoking, which I do think is appropriate, then the plan isn't to tax cigarettes. The plan is to register cigarette smokers and allow them to be migrated out of existence. It is an addictive substance. Kids shouldn't be allowed to smoke, and that would solve both problems. You don't need to tax poor people out of their rights. I mean, liberty is a right, okay? Poor people have a right to fair access to the liberty. And if you allow excessive taxation, you destroy liberty. It's just that, it's just a fact. You make it inaccessible to people who are poor. It's just a fact, asshole. And especially when the tax goes beyond any justifiable compensation for a social cost. So you lose on all accounts. Fuck you, you're an idiot. You're more than an idiot. Like I said, you've heard me make these arguments. You can't quote me ever talking about how it would be a good idea to tax liberty. I've only argued that if you're going to tax cigarettes, then let's tax fat foods. Let's tax all the other stuff that we can justify some sort of health benefit. So let's tax the fuck out of the alcohol and tax the fuck out of the fatty food, and then at least you'll have some kind of equity. Then the pain will be spread evenly instead of the way it is now, where the pain is spread so disproportionately. It'll still be insane because you'll be collecting all your tax from poor people with vices, which I think is just evil. But at least it won't be double evil. The way it is now is double evil. You're exploiting poor people, you're exploiting addicts, and you're exploiting them with an outrageous exploitation. Not just a minor exploitation, a preposterous exploitation. Now, fuck you. God, you really suck. So much. So anyway, I shall continue and be back. Well, I'm moving along, but boy, it's taking forever. Anyway, so he made some crack about Vloggerdome being a shitty website. He said he made some suggestions that I didn't pay attention to. Unfortunately, he couldn't think of any of them to mention, because I'd sure like to hear what they were. Yeah, right. Daisies on the front page or something? What was your suggestion? And he doesn't even get, I'd still be doing the Vloggerdome thing. If the stupid template software didn't crash because of GoDaddy's bullshit, I'd still be there. The problem would be people wouldn't be able to upload videos because I was running out of disk space anyways, you know, on the server. So, you know, there were limitations. But there was my failures on that one, okay? I'd still be there right now. I was getting 300-400 views on videos there. Wasn't that bad. So fuck you. You know. And it ain't dead yet. I'm still going to come up with a new vlogger dome. So fuck you. Yeah, just fuck you. Then he brought up my dead sister, you know, because I made a little joke about the porn thing, you know, with his sister. And yeah, your sister's not dead, and your sister's probably not doing porn, right? Probably. Well, maybe she is, right? That's why it's a suitable counter joke, is because your sister actually is a fucking herpes-infested slut, you know, doing dog porn. And that's why it's a suitable counter-argument to bring up my dead sister. Because, yeah, my sister is actually dead. It's not a joke. She's actually dead. Yeah, she is actually worm food, that's right. God, you just suck. You just suck. Anyway, then he brought up some sort of tea partier in liberal clothing or something. Again, what percentage of my policy initiatives written down would the Tea Party endorse? What percentage? 2%? Yeah, sorry. What you're saying, they would love. They would endorse this video you just made. Yes, God save the corporation. That's you know... That's their motto, and all you would do is change it to a possible speculative, maybe possible spaghetti monster, save the corporation, or whatever you believe in. Monks, or gunks, or gorks, or porks. Porks. Yeah, you believe in porks. All right, he says that public access TV didn't happen the way I said. Well, that's just bullshit. He says it was a network conspiracy, right? So the three networks conspired to get a cable bill written that had public access TV in it because that somehow would make them look more attractive or something. Yeah, bullshit. It was in there because people knew that the transition to cable TV, they saw what was happening. They saw that it was all paid content and there was no public anything anymore. Except for PBS is, you know, small contribution. And PBS was being definanced by Reagan. Well, did get definanced. So he thinks a monopoly means that you have to have, there's no other people providing any service. So you can't be called a monopoly until every other frickin' business is out of business. So if you're like, some kind of whatever that flower company is, and you do 99% of the business, but there's still one flower shop in Wetoka, Wisconsin, that means that you're not a monopoly, because there's still one. And if you're Hearst newspaper and you own 80% of the publications in the country, you're not a monopoly, because there's still 20% you don't own. I mean, it's just a stupid, ignorant way of looking at it. The point of monopolies is whether there's a competitive provider for the service. Do they have a competitive provider? That's how you define a monopoly, dumbass. God, you're so fucking... Why am I wasting my time talking? I didn't realize you were this fucking stupid. My fault. My bad. My bad for not realizing you're as dumb as you look and sound and act. Yeah, my bad. All right, this part, I mean, it's 2 seconds later, but he says something like, this is so outrageous. Okay, Indifferent Sky... Yeah, you posted your comment on the video after this video. So you must have watched this video. So yeah, I'm just blocking you. I'm just hating on you for the rest of my life. Because how could you watch this? This is just, this piece right here is going to be the most disgusting pile of crap to come out of this scumbag's mouth.
Also, Gary, it's fucking hilarious that you're fucking arguing for the public interest when you have said you would fuck schools. Fuck giving taxes, fuck property taxes, going to fucking schools and shit.
Alright, now, anybody who knows anything about my videos or anything about my politics on this subject knows that I don't think they should finance anything like that with fucking property taxes. That's right, I think property taxes are an insanely stupid regressive tax. That's right. You don't pay for education that way. First off, it's incredibly discriminatory because, yeah, the poor districts can't finance their schools. The rich districts get all the, you know, have plenty of money to do it. So, yeah, it's totally disproportional and inequitable. It should be done with if you're going to tax for schools, it should be taxed on the state level or even the federal level. I think it should be a federal obligation. If we're going to say people have to pay for this publicly, if we have to pay for public education, then yeah, it should be a federal tax. And all the schools should be the same everywhere. All right? Yeah, everybody gets the same thing. There's no way this argument he's making, like somehow I would not educate kids, it's absolute bullshit. And I have a whole fucking channel devoted to this subject of not paying teachers and paying kids instead. And he knows that, so it's not about the money and it's not about keeping kids stupid. So this is just a fucking lie. What a fucking goddamn skanky goddamn alligator cunt. I mean, he's just the scummiest reptilian cunt. He's not even fucking even close to being a mammalian cunt. Fuck you for that. That's disgusting. I mean, that's not an accident. Shit. This is so depressing. I just, the kids all the time. I mean, he's as bad as his friend. He's a lying cunt. It's just lie after lie after lie. So he makes this argument that somehow the BBC was better than the American regulated version of television. So, I mean, you know, just think about it for a minute. All the shows from like the 60s, you know, the early 70s all the way on, you know, all the shows that American television produced would have been thrown in the crapper so we could have the Straining Cranberries show. I mean, the BBC had a couple of winners, but it was a couple of winners, all right? 99% of what was on the BBC sucked, Edible. They were watching our shows on the BBC. So fuck you, you're so stupid. So yeah, and he says, I'm not in the real world because I don't somehow don't understand that. What a crock of shit. Cosmos, well, as a public PBS, and PBS is a perfect model in my opinion. Yeah, let's just create a nice public library style. That's like the public library style. You subsidize it a little bit, you give it a little bit of commercial value too, and yeah, let that run. That is a much better game. So anyway, why did it fail? Why did it change? Look, the why is easy. Ronald Reagan, jackass. Exactly what you're talking about. Deregulation. Not regulation, deregulation. That's what you're advocating for. You're advocating for not regulating YouTube. That's what you're saying in these videos, shithead. You don't understand that? And that's what destroyed everything of value that we did have. You stupid fucking idiot. We now have cable TV where you're paying a cable bill and you have the commercials. So now you're getting both, right? The whole point, when the cable first came out, it was kick-ass, because, yeah, you paid your $29, and you got a bunch of fucking no-commercial television. And then they just fucking reintroduced the same shit all over again, because it got deregulated. And all of a sudden they said, okay, yeah, you can have 5 minutes of commercials, and then it went to 10 minutes, and then it went to fucking a half an hour, and then it went to fuck regulations, let them do whatever the fuck they want. And then you had the TBS ripoff where you'd say, yeah, we're going to let you watch The Godfather, we're going to cut out all the good scenes, and we'll only put 10 minutes of commercials in the first hour, and then we'll just fucking make the next hour and a half drag on for 3 fucking hours. Fuck you. I have to play this part because you're going to say something outrageous.
Fucking shit. You are.
As the rules applied to all of them, so it created a fair battlefield, but also created a public interest battlefield. The public won. You shithead.
No, I guess it's back here for
you. You meth addict.
Oh, meth addict. I haven't heard that one.
Like the British broadcasting.
Okay, let's do this part.
So you would have taxed people to create TV for people. You don't think that the American version was much better?
In all honesty, Gary, if we're fucking comparing like fucking BBC and ITV and that shit to the fucking American fucking system, fuck yeah, it was fucking better. Have you seen some of the fucking shows on BBC? And also, Gary, unlike fucking here, educational and fucking educational type shows and shows that are for the public good are not confined to one fucking channel like they are here, like with PBS.
Yeah, right. And like, I wouldn't be for that, right? So again, that doesn't even, so this is almost an irrelevant part. The only thing of value from the BBC was the stuff that was basically the for the public good stuff, right? The nature shows and shit. The rest of the BBC did suck.
Or C-SPAN or stuff like that. It's spread out because once those fucking corporations like the BBC and ITV take the fucking taxpayer money, they are fucking beholden to the fucking taxpayer. They are beholden to do good by the fucking taxpayer. That's how fucking shit works, Gary. Fucking sorry. Again, you don't live in the fucking real world, and I fucking do.
So whatever, again, just, you know, so basically he's saying that the BBC model was better than the American, let's just regulate it a little bit model, which I think is a crock, absolute crock of shit. Who's watching more of whose TV on their TVs now, the British or us? Yeah.
Yeah, you let private corporations play around, you let them do things differently. Some have more commercials, some have less commercials, but you regulate how many commercials they can have as a maximum number. What the fuck was wrong with that? Oh, that's right, absolutely nothing. Because it forced all of the...
Well, obviously there fucking was something wrong with it, because that's not the fucking system we have now. Fucking all the fucking cable channels are owned by three fucking companies now. It's basically an extension of fucking network television.
Right. By deregulation. So again, what's your fucking argument? You're the one arguing in favor of deregulation and unregulation and non-regulation. I'm arguing for regulation. Gee, duh, stupid fuck.
Television. So, yeah, Gary, it was a really great fucking system. Too bad it died like a fucking dodo.
Yeah, it didn't die like a dodo bird. Assholes like you killed it, okay? You paranoid anti-government lunatics are the ones who killed it. Reagan, Reaganite.
They all had to compete with the same standards. It wasn't unfair to NBC or CBS or ABC. It became...
Then why were they so fucking scared of cable, Gary?
Now, what does this have to do with cable TV? Absolutely nothing, right? We're talking about when TV was regulated. The regulation of cable TV was obviously much later. I'm talking about the regulation of regular TV that took place in the 70s, in the 60s too. But I mean, in the 70s. All right, and some of it was really shit, okay? You couldn't swear and all that kind of crap. But I mean, some of it was real good stuff. And that's what I'm talking about here. Now he's changing the subject. Somehow now now he's putting those words in my mouth. He's basically saying that I was somehow saying that networks weren't afraid of cable TV when it came around. Of course they were. But the networks had nothing to do with public access being part of cable regulation. I mean, this asshole thinks that because there's a regulation, it can only be for one interest is controlling all the regulation. There's not separate interests with separate interests. I mean, it's just so fucking stupid. No, there's people with different liberty interests who decide to regulate cable, cut television for different fucking reasons, retard. Well, anyway, enough.
Like,
I guess enough of this.
Why? But,
again, so again, just to imply that I somehow believe that networks weren't scared as fuck of goddamn cable TV. Of course they were. Duh. But look who won in the end, right? Because they made deals in the end. All right, and the deal was they got five channels on cable. You know, somehow they won in the end, didn't they? All right, well, we got further along. So we started another video. This was the one where I was really tired. So, you know, the video where my video got flagged. So anyway, I'll play that later. So anyway, let's finish this up. So again, he was kept harping on this free speech thing, and the argument is about, he's saying that I'm saying that the Constitution applies to YouTube. I've never said that. I've never said there's any law currently. There's common law. That would be my argument. That under common law, the fact that other institutions are regulated, that similar things have to be treated similar under that context, I think somebody could win a lawsuit right now against YouTube for discrimination and inequitable application of its terms of service. It doesn't apply its terms of service evenly. There's overt discrimination, in my opinion. I think it can be proven. So in that sense, I think they are violating law. constitutionally based law. But I've certainly said in my videos, I've been quite clear, I've used the word regulation about 7,000 times. So I've made it clear that first you have to regulate it before the Constitution can be protected. The whole point is that, yes, Congress established through the enforcement agencies, the FCC and whatnot, the existence of public access television to solve a problem. And through that mechanism, the Supreme Court said, now you have a mechanism, now you have an instrument. And once you have the instrument, the same standards apply. So there we have First Amendment rights in this real world, and in this other world on TV, you have First Amendment rights. So when the cable companies, they were the ones who ran the public access stations originally, they couldn't discriminate. They had to apply the same free speech rights we had in the real world, they had to apply in the television world regarding obscenity. And so that was the point I was making, is the Supreme Court has endorsed free speech on television through that regulated mechanism. And I'm saying that we should have the same mechanism on the internet. If we're not going to create the public square, if we're not going to create the actual infrastructure, the place, then we have to regulate the places that do exist to create the instrument that you can now have free speech. Duh. Not that complicated. So he just lies when he keeps saying, I'm saying the Constitution now applies to YouTube. I never said that. That's why I said, technically, you're right. But again, it's only technically, because I think right now you could file a lawsuit against Google and you could make a good case that it is violating the law by discriminating and violating its own contract, its own terms of service, it's violating. All right, anyway. So then the other issue you had to bring up again was why do I flag people? I don't flag them, I DMCA them, but anyway, I suppress their free speech when they violated what I consider to be first my copyright. I intend to protect my copyright. That's right. I believe if I produce material, I own it first. I get to do derivatives first. And they have to use fair use to use it. And I'm saying explicitly, I don't think there's any possible way you can be malicious and call it fair use. There's no malicious use that can be considered fair use. So if your intent in the use is malicious, it could never be fair use. And I wanted to take that to court and prove that to be a fact. And there was nothing wrong with me doing that. The real point is here, I don't personally think Photoshop is free speech. I don't think it should be. In the past, they forced artists to characterize people, to draw pictures. Yeah, draw your own picture. You want to draw a picture of somebody? Go ahead. But Photoshop is bullshit. And I don't know if you can actually apply a law that way, but I think it's bullshit. And I think once you go down that road, it's bullshit. It's a bad road to go down, totally destructive to any kind of civil human communication. Because people just end up photoshopping each other's families and shit, their kids. I mean, it just goes nowhere good. So I think it is bullshit. I think you have to make the content yourself. If you can't make the argument out of your own faculties, you have no right to steal somebody else's material. Use that for your malicious purpose. Malicious purpose is not fair use. 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 All right. I mean, how many fucking times you gotta say that, right? Sorry, Gary, that's not the way it is. Money. So he's making this argument again about money controlling everything, and my argument is exactly right. That's why you have to regulate it. Again, you won't just say, yes, I would think regulation be the way to go. You won't say the words, so you're against the regulation that makes the money less powerful. So you're just voting for the money system, shithead. I'm voting against it by saying regulate protections. You're saying fuck protections, money should run the show. Public television, public access TV came from the three networks. You go ahead and try to prove that. I think that's the most preposterous nonsense theory of your idiotic theories. You'd have to show to me how somehow it's going to hurt. It would help network television to have public access television on it. Now, if you want to say the two laws ended up carrying each other, that there was support for public access TV, and there was a minor amount of support for the networks having access to cable, and so two minorities combined to create a coalition to pass the law. Maybe that's possible, okay, but it wasn't the networks that drove public access TV. That's just bullshit, and I think you goddamn know it. All right, PBS was created for rich people to get tax write-offs. I don't know where your evidence for that is. I never even heard of that theory, so you're going to have to show me what institution and how there was some theory somebody had about, okay, let's change these low-budget educational networks into a major national public network and call it PBS. You're going to have to show me, and you're going to have to show me how the original PBS wasn't even financed by the government, so you're going to show me again how this is just some kind of scheme rich people came up with to get tax write-offs. I think it's just bullshit. You could almost say it about any charity, and I just think it's kind of a dangerous accusation if you got absolutely no evidence. So I don't know where your fingerprint trail is, or where your paper trail is, or your money trail is, but what evidence are you basing that on? Or are you just Alex Jonesing? It sounds like you're just Alex Jonesing. It sounds like you just hate anything made by government or supported by government, and you're just going to slander it. I mean, to slander PBS, the company gave us Cosmos and Nova, Frontline, Bill Buckley, I mean, all kinds of shit. And you're going to sit there and say, yeah, it was just a tax dodge. Fuck you. Arguing that I think YouTube has to act to protect free speech without regulation. Yeah, okay, so he's just arguing, like I said. I've said the word regulation, I just said it again. Just a lie to say I haven't said it, I haven't made it clear. You have to regulate it before the Constitution can apply. The Constitution can't apply until you regulate it. Duh. Laws and constitutional amendments are different things. Laws and constitutional amendments are different things. Like he's arguing that to me. Like I said, where in my video? You can't find a single place where I don't realize that. So fuck you, you lying cunt. Frankly, yeah, I wrote down here, Rob is a better person than Napalm. As much as I think Rob is a liar, he doesn't seem to be as overt a liar as Napalm is. So he did the to be honest thing. I didn't like Gary anyway, and I thought he was full of shit anyway, and I just hung around because, yeah, he didn't hate me, and, maybe I could feed off of his subscribers or something. So he basically admitted it. So all you assholes, again, who gave me a hard time because I treated Napalm poorly, this is the guy, okay? So I win again. I win again. Even when I'm wrong, I'm right, right? I just can't lose somehow. Alright, then he did the stupid thing with the Fred thing. And again, Fred's video was about P2P for free speech. And again, the fact that YouTube sucks and has assholes on it has nothing to do with the fact of whether free speech should be on the back alleys of the internet. Free speech shouldn't have to go to the back alleys. And so then again, he used Fred's line, people are the public square. What the fuck does that mean? It doesn't mean anything. All right, the reason why you have a public square isn't to talk to people you already know. It isn't to talk to people who already heard what you had to say. The whole point of having free speech and public access television and fair time and all this other kind of legislation is to talk to people you don't get a chance to talk to. I mean, that's the whole fucking point of it, is to have somebody read your book who hasn't read your book. That's the whole point of having it in the library. I mean, this asshole would let Google own the congressional fucking goddamn library. Let Google run it. Let Google do the Dewey Decimal System and all this shit. Right? Oh yeah, let's just sell it off to a private corporation and trust them. Fuck you. Alright, the Constitution doesn't apply to YouTube. Again, I can't go over it more times. But the fact of the matter is, the Constitution would apply if we had consistent laws. The fact is, we did regulate regular television. The fact is, we did regulate cable television. And the fact is, it's time to regulate the internet for these basic minimums protecting our basic constitutional rights. Our basic constitutional rights should be protected. It's just bullshit. All right, then he made some crack about this Rob thing. Coughlin and Zomgitz are friends of Rob's. Well, already, they use Zomgitz as an example. Like, somehow I haven't called her out on it. I have. When she came here to visit, it was, I think, one time, and there was some other... It must have been in person, because I really haven't talked to her otherwise. Well, it might have been in Stickham, actually. Tell you the truth, it might have been in Stickham. But I already called her on the Rob thing. I said, what the fuck? The guy's a creepy motherfucker. And she had some sympathetic story. Well, he's been raped by 9 million people, and he's a little bit psychotic, and he's a little got this, and he's got problems, and blah, 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 blah. And I was like, well, bullshit. He's a fucking asshole. And so I did call her on it. So fuck you on that one. I'm not a hypocrite. I'm not duplicitous. Unlike you, I'm not a dishonest motherfucker. Unlike you, I don't do the, well, to be honest, I did think you were a fat, smelly cunt all along. Because that's not what I thought. I thought you were, potentially, a great human being. And I just was, like, totally fucking shocked to find out you're really a you're a fucking poop eater. And pooper. You're a poop pooper. Yeah. Let's see, my videos on that shit. Oh yeah, they made some comment, like somehow when I started saying something about YouTube's history that I got it from one of your videos. What a crock of shit. Go ahead and show me one fucking comment I've made where you said I got it from you. Fuck you, that's bullshit. Unless I'll find one of my videos where I said it long before you did, you stupid jerk. I've gotten nothing from you. Nothing. Except now, a huge pile of aggravation. They didn't use, oh, they didn't lose the K, so he's basically saying that, VeriSign, that's not VeriSign, Viacom, that Viacom didn't lose the fucking Google case. Of course it did, it lost the case, and if there wasn't a settlement, it was on the appeal. So the case law stands, okay? Google, YouTube won, even though they admitted to stealing all the content deliberately just to make billions of dollars selling the company on the value of the content they stole. So that's the legal precedent now. Yeah, that is as crazy as it is. That's the legal precedent now on copyright law, that somehow it's okay to steal a bunch of content if you can get away with it. So if you can get around the DMCA and all that shit right now, if you can find some sneaky way to get around it and you can steal the content and you can get away with it, you can profit from it and it's okay. That's sort of the case law that stands. So the fact is, the judge decided in YouTube's favor. That's the case law. The settlement wouldn't change the case law. So that's the standing case law. Google won. Bitch and more. Oh, bitch and moan. Yeah, no, that's not all I'm doing. So again, some of these accusations, I'm just sitting here bitching and moaning. No, I've proposed all kinds of things about how you could change the system and what laws you could implement and propose. So that's just a lie and just bullshit. I'm doing the best I can. I think I'm doing better than anybody else you can point to. I think I'm doing a hell of a lot better than your friend Rob. So fuck you. Or even your skeptical heretic friend, or any of your other douchebag friends. So, fuck you all over the place. Till dead, preferably. He says these amazing things, too. You know, like I said, he did the rag on my dead sister, and what other thing did he go for? Oh, yeah, my stroke. So he went after that one, too, and he's like, if I get what I deserve, I should have a stroke. I mean, yeah, if I get what I deserve, I should die quickly, so hopefully it will be maybe a stroke and takes me out fast, but that's sort of what I deserve, because that's what I've been advocating for, is the right for people to die quickly and gracefully. So, yeah, that would be what I deserve. So, yeah, but you really should get what you deserve, which is to be buried alive in a big, giant pile of shit. All right, then he brought up the French Revolution thing, where, I got it wrong, and, backwards, which one was first. Bravo on you. There you got me on that technicality. It sort of is a technicality. Something proven wrong. Yeah, I don't know what that is. Oh, that's it. So anyway, we got through that okay, right? That wasn't too bad. He hasn't made one valid point in the whole fucking video. Not one. It's all been absolute shit. So we'll play a little bit of this and then just to see what it is. I mean, he's playing my... I got flagged video.
Gary is the first one to yell and scream at you if you use cult-like fucking like cult-like lexicon against him. But, oh, he's the first one to be like, Napalm's followers, Napalmites, they flagged me. Again, Gary, yeah.
Well, who else would have, right? I mean, your video, the video I responded to, you said, the video before that one, when you were talking to the fat guy, you said some outrageous things, and that video didn't get flagged. I mean, I'm just saying that it's quite obvious that why would my video get flagged? It wasn't that bad a video. I didn't come anywhere close to being as disgusting as you just were in this video, talking about my dead sister and then telling me to have a stroke and die and all that kind of crap. And then you told me in another part of the video, I think you said, get run over or some other kind of crap. I mean, you know, and so there was nothing like that in my video. So this is just such bullshit. You know, I mean, who else flagged my video except some buddy of yours? That's all I said. I didn't say he had a cult. I just said it's one of these little napalmites, one of these little suck-offense, you know, over here. That's all. Machine Ghost XX? What is that? Yeah, whatever. Yeah, he's incomprehensible anyway, so I don't even know what he's... I guess he's being satirical. Yeah. Anyway, so let's play... So yeah, let's go.
Fucking, you got proof of that, Gary? You got fucking proof of that? Or it's like everything else you've fucking said, did you just pull that shit right out of your fucking ass?
Yeah, I pulled it right out of my fucking ass. I think I didn't say anything specific, did I? I just said, isn't it strange? Isn't this kind of ironic that I get flagged on a napalm response video? I mean, of all the videos you think I'm not going to get flagged on, it would be a response video to the most offensive, disgusting sack of fat pig shit on the internet. I mean, really, it's the kind of video you say, why the fuck would that get flagged? It's just like The Amazing Atheist or something. Well, how the fuck do you possibly get flagged responding to one of his videos? Oh yeah, it has to be one of his sycophants, right? Duh. Jeez. Pretty easy to figure out. So anyway, I'll play the rest of this and then finish up. Alright, we're back to finish up. So yeah, so he plays the two videos where I was dead tired. Just talking about the flag video and the harassment where I have to go to one of my other channels and do this bullshit all over again. So anyway, and lots of rags about how I look. I mean, even little Peachy throws in one of these little lines here. Where is it? Yeah, I'll have to block all these assholes, of course. More lines on his face than a mirror at Studio 54. I wonder what she's going to look like when she's 54. Maybe somebody could Photoshop a peach at 53. The guy she's hanging out with, right? He hasn't aged too well the last couple of years either. So, she shouldn't be talking. But whatever. You know, we can all make jokes about that one, too. Right? Yeah. It's all fair game, apparently, in videos. This is what you're applauding. You're applauding talking about my dead sister. I mean, really. I mean, you know, how low do you assholes want to go? I mean, is that what the game you want to play? Because you're going to lose the game. You want to play his game, by his rules, against you. You're not going to like the game. Trust me. But it's okay, whatever. So just for context again, too, you know, I'm not too concerned with how I look, but, you know, yeah, I did have, you know, it's been a rough 2 months. I mean, I had Lyme disease and then 2 ear infections, so it's been a rough couple of months. But, yeah, I could have facial hair would help, right? I mean, napalm hides behind his beard, you know, so why don't you shave that shit so people can see really how hideous you are? But yeah, I mean, obviously I could hide a little bit of this, but I don't. And I don't even try to have decent lighting. And I don't even find my better side, which is over here. Right? I don't even try to do that. But I could. But yeah, it really just doesn't matter because this is who I am and it's okay with me. I don't like the fact that I'm old, but yeah, it's just happening. And I can't do much about it. So, gee. But I'm not going to feel bad about it. I mean, I had, you know, there's no way you're going to be able to compete with the run I had. So fuck you. Good luck, suckers. You get what you deserve, you know. Anyway, so then the other, you know, just a little critique of this, you know, edible napalm. He's talking about me not watching or playing people's videos. I mean, I've played more people's videos than anybody, I think. I don't think you could find somebody else on the internet who's played more videos, complete videos of other people than me. So it's just a bogus, idiotic, retarded, completely insane accusation to make that I respond to videos without playing them, because most of the time I do. And the only time I don't is when the video is an hour and 7 minutes long. Are just completely insane. But whatever. It's just a stupid accusation. It is. It's a stupid accusation. Alright, so then the thing about, so he made the counter-accusation that every time somebody gets flagged for making an in-mendum video, it was my supporters. Yeah, I would agree that if you get flagged for just making an in-mendum video, then yeah, it's probably somebody who supports me, and I'd say it's the wrong thing to do. That's all. I'm not saying that wouldn't be a reasonable conclusion for somebody to draw, but go ahead and show me the videos that have been flagged. You said the Carnal Virtues had a video flagged. Well, show me the video, and let's make sure there wasn't flagged for some other goddamn reason besides the users doing it. You know, in the sense that when YouTube looked at it, it was obviously a violation in that content. So, I mean, you know, let's make sure there's the same standards are being applied. All right, and the only argument I'm going to make is of the videos I've had flagged, the one to you was the tamest, and the one I was responding to was the most obnoxious. So I'm just saying that's kind of ironic, retard. But yeah, you're too stupid to understand that argument. That's all there was. And so there was just a bunch more insults about how I look, which is hilarious coming from, you know, the guy who's got, like, every bad thing market cornered. I mean, really, he's got nothing going for him. But I guess that's why he's, yeah, it's like his psychology needs to do something. Let's see. Eminem looks like the bad guy from Showgirls. You know, I'm not Showgirls, so I can't do much with that. He's also the greatest speed writer and orator in human history. I don't know what that means. Gary looks like a retarded and even more drug-addled version of Dave Mustaine. Like I said, I love the fact that I look like somebody. Let's see what you look like. Oh, you look like generic human. Oh, well, sorry for you. Yeah, so whatever. I'm beyond my way. I don't think I'll be coming back to any more edible napalm videos. And this is like the most retarded, stupid, pointless, idiotic, content depraved video I've responded to. I mean, there was just nothing here. He wasn't right on a single point made. And it's just anybody who can defend this as anything but a awful video is too stupid. Piro. Yeah, I mean, you better not leave a comment on this video. Just fair warning. Unless it's going to be something like, are you fucking retarded? I mean, you've been soaking your fucking goddamn marijuana in Vagisil or something, because your brain is fucking goddamn rotten. Yeah. I mean, this was just a horrid, horrid, hard, hard video. So anyway, as to Coughlin hanging out with the Rob guy, I don't know what that's about either, but, you know, Coughlin hangs out with a lot of people I got no respect for, so, you know, you can't do much with the, you know, when you have a bastard son, you know. It's not likely to go anywhere good. So anyway, Unseen Purity, I guess that's his new name or something. This is some sort of Mendham Court scene one. I think the Photoshop is a good argument, though. I mean, is this what all you want to do? You just want to Photoshop everybody who goes on the internet and just Photoshop, and they call that free speech? I just think that is just too lame. Way too lame. Yeah. Pitifully lame. I mean, you could have, like, you know, just have robots do it, right? Eventually we could just have bots that just Photoshop people endlessly. What a Wonderful World. Brought to you by, I don't know, Napalm the Booger Eater. Yeah, there's nothing to say. So anyway, till next, one of these kind of disgusting related videos. Hey, there's me. Look a little cranky there. Anyway. And so, I don't think I'll be back to edible napalm, so. See ya. Yeah. So long, fucker. Get what you deserve as soon as possible. And that will be all.